Welcome, Aries, to your, August bonus love reading. I hope everybody is doing well. If you are new to my channel, welcome to Charlie Tarot, and feel free to subscribe. Also, you guys, please be careful with the scammers out there. They are actually using, you know, our pictures now and having you, you know, try to get readings or offer readings to you through an email. So I would just be careful with those scammers. Now, if you are new, welcome and feel free to subscribe. We do nothing but love readings here. I am going to use the AF Tarot deck to pull some energies, and then I am using the Soul Cards Tarot, my favorite deck, for the main spread. And then, of course, the situations to see what's going on with your situation. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started with the AF Tarot deck. Also, I am going to pull the love oracles to see what this person has to say to you, and then some other cards along the way. So your cards have already been shuffled. So let's see what's coming in for Aries. Love it. We have the Magician, synchronicities and manifestation. We have the Nine of Swords. Okay. Conflict and anguish. Justice. Ace of Swords, a big breakthrough coming in. It looks like there may be some conflict mentally. Okay, swords are about mental, or the mind. So there could be something going on here that's causing a bit of anxiety or stress. There is a breakthrough coming in, as maybe somebody not taking accountability of their actions. This is a very unbalanced energy that you could be dealing with, maybe a one-sided connection. But I feel like justice, there's like a feeling of justice needing to be served. We do have the Magician, so there are synchronicities and your angels around you at this time sending you signs, okay? And also, this is having all the tools within this situation. So if this is a legal matter, I feel you're on the right side of the legal matter, okay? But there could be some worry here. Now, there is some type of breakthrough, communication, mental clarity, and this is asking you to have focus at this time, because there was a very painful ending, okay, or something here. You could only go up from here. So this says karmic lessons, and we also have the Five of Cups energy due to the Temperance in reverse. So yeah, very, very unbalanced energy. I feel like this person put you through a lot of sadness. We have a fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. So this could be your energy, or could be somebody that you're dealing with. But this is all about leadership and success. It is coming up upright, male or female. So I do feel like something is coming into balance for you guys. Okay, a lot of mental clarity, lots of truth, communication, if that. So let's cut the deck and see what else is coming through. You actually have all the power. The Magician's very powerful. It actually can create anything and to bring it into life, okay? Five of Pentacles in reverse. We have the Four of Cups. Knight of Swords. Ooh, what a reckless energy. That's the challenge, is this Knight of Swords. Could be an air sign, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Mutual energies is going in a new direction. This person, for some of you guys, could be in a relationship, okay? But we're going to get more into it. Yeah, Four of Cups, Page of Pentacles. Now, let's say this person is in a relationship. They're not very happy. They're not going in their committal. Okay. Let's just keep going. Yeah. Something is going to be revealed to you. You're going to get the truth, no matter what, if you haven't already. The universe is going to reveal everything to you here. No, nothing's not going to be a mystery. So everything that was happening behind the scenes is coming to light, or already did. The Ten of Cups is showing in the outcome some type of shattered dreams, feeling like a very unhappy ending with a connection. Okay. And I feel it has a lot to do with that Justice card. Now, you're coming up here as the Queen of Pentacles with the High Priestess in reverse. It's a need to reconnect with spirit. This is for you to trust your intuition, trust yourself. Okay. Believe in yourself. Believe what you saw in this connection. Believe that you were, you know, treated wrongly. okay? There's no self-doubting at this time. You have a very powerful card on your side. You're very connected with spirit. This person, I feel, does things out of impulse, anger, for reactions. The Knight of Swords in the challenge is a very reckless energy. Could be very cold with their words, very in and out, very unpredictable. So I feel like this is what caused you to kind of recover from this energy, or start to recover as you're seeing things clearly coming towards the outcome, okay? So this may be a feeling of feeling anxiety, feeling hurt, not really knowing what's going to come next. But justice here, there is an injustice and karma's at play. Now, with the Queen of Pentacles energy, such a beautiful energy to have as the overall. So this is a grounding energy. Could be a single parent here. This is a person who works alone, very independent, and very grounded and responsible, loyal and reliable. Okay, you have gave nothing but nurturing love to an energy. That's how you operate, okay? You're someone to rely on. Now with the Fool, this is having the confidence to move forward. So this is all about new beginnings. Your intuition, yes, is at play. There may be things that you may not know as of right now, but it's asking you to take that leap of faith, okay? To a new beginning, to a new journey. There's a new start here for you. And I feel like you're in the process of doing that. The more and more things start getting in, more revealed to you. There is somebody here that is being very dishonest, has lots of secrets, yes. And then we do have the Six of Pentacles here. Yeah, see, as you're very wise individual, so there could be a withdrawal, but this is more of you finding the light within yourself. This person could do whatever the hell they want, okay? They obviously have some issues of how they behave, okay? They go possibly, you know, into situations that they try, that only benefits them for temporary happiness. This person is coming up as a Knight of Swords. So they're coming in as a travel energy, very immature. Okay. You're coming up more of the Queen energy, and very stable and grounded. This person's reckless. Okay. And I feel like with this energy, to find balance, is that you already have all the answers. It's now trusting yourself and putting the trust into the universe. With this situation, it does not feel good, because it feels like there's something that's, you know, possibly consumes your mind a bit, or you could be thinking of something over and over again, or it just pops up, right? And it kind of like, ugh. But you have all the power to shift your mindset, to go within. You have all the answers with that Hermit card. So it's a beautiful energy that you're carrying, because what you're dealing with is somebody very, very spiritually immature, not spiritually wise, okay? This is someone who's, again, keeps doing something here, just impulsive, rushing, reckless, ruthless. I mean, it's just like, what? And you're over here like, I'm gonna, you know, move towards this new beginning here and detach my emotions. Probably feels a bit like left out in the cold, yes, but again, it's all about the perspective, okay? And then I feel like your angels are by your side, and this is a need to believe and trust. All right, I'm just gonna shuffle this really quickly. Yeah, this person literally, like, their actions is like non-committal to anyone they go to, okay? Anyone. Very selfish. Very, you know, I wouldn't say selfish. They're just, well, yeah, they are. Immature, not self-aware. Okay. Yeah, embarrassing, right? Embarrassing. They feel embarrassed. This person could be like keeping you out in the cold because they don't even want to deal with their own, like, because you're probably so honest, right? Or very loyal. And you like speak the truth. So I feel with this feeling is they're feeling threatened by you. Like you see right through them, like you know what they're about. So that's kind of like when somebody doesn't want to look in the mirror, or they're like acting in a childish behavior, they're not really wanting to face the truth. And you're the truth. Okay, so they run away from the truth. So if that's running away from you, that's what they're doing. It's very, very immature, but they are embarrassed. They feel like a clown. So I guess they have to go ahead and try to fool someone else, but I mean, yeah, this is closed and trapped and frustrated, SOS, right? So this person also could be in jail. I'm getting that. I don't mean to laugh, but I just saw the fence here. and locked up, basically. This person is very tunnel vision like, I feel. This person, I feel, you know, frustrates themselves because it's very hard to constantly justify your behavior and not be truthful to yourself. So this person, I feel, is lying to themselves a lot and always trying to justify their actions by lying, right? And that's a lot of work to do, especially with the Knight of Swords, who does things out of impulsiveness all the time. So I feel they're more frustrated with themselves, yeah, and that this situation's done. It does look like there is an emotional detachment, a big one, in the mutual energies. They might act like they don't care, but you're going to see something where you're really wanting to take that leap of faith and leave this person behind. I feel like this person did enough, you know, to you. I feel like they brought enough sadness. They brought enough worry and anxiety. I feel like you're just tired of feeling that way, okay? And I feel like in the outcome, yes, it does feel hurtful. It does feel like, you know, if, especially if you've been with this person for many, many years, it's like, well, I invested that much time on an energy, you know? But I feel like with you, you're coming up on top, you know? You're going towards the full energy. Beautiful. I mean, we could already see what you're doing with, what you're dealing with. Yeah. This person could have a white car. I feel like the more that you turn your back on this energy, regardless if they're with somebody else, okay? I mean, it has nothing to do, like, with you being loyal and loving and caring, okay? It has to do with their selfish ways, their immaturity, once again, because you're coming up very beautiful, regardless. I mean, yes, we can get in arguments with people. We could say some hurtful things. But in the end, you know you've been a good person, okay, to this energy. You could have been provoked a lot of times, you know, triggered a lot of times also yourself. But I feel like with this person, they could be now triggered because you're turning your back on them. And they feel like embarrassed, okay, embarrassed. Oh, look at this, synchronicities. Again, the Magician. This is you listening to the signs of the universe. So we have 11-11, 2-2-2-3-3-3. And I'm getting 4-4-4. You guys could be seeing 12-12. Okay. Any repeating numbers, please look that up because it's always a sign, a message in there. We also have TikTok on the bottom of the deck. So something you could find out on TikTok for some of you guys. But also there's a deadline running out. This person feels like they might have run out of chances, be feeling the pressure. But let's see. And love. Oh, running and avoiding. Let's get one more. So someone definitely, there is a love situation here. And we have confession. Regardless if this is a confession from them, something is going to be revealed. And we have, you know, an energy that is hiding behind a clown mask. Okay. And it looks like they could be making fake social medias or trying to find out information about you on what you're doing. But either way, if somebody wants to confess, this could be a new situation for some of you of somebody wanting to confess the love to you, but or how they feel about you. But where Aries is going is more towards the full, new beginnings, brighter days ahead for Aries. Okay. All right, let's go ahead. Excuse me. Let's go ahead and grab, see what this person has to say to you. I need time. Oh my gosh. I need time to make up a story. Isn't that weird? I just got that. Oh, look at, yeah. Third party. There is a third party or there was. Okay. That is for some. Please take what resonates. You would only know that. You are the love of my life. This was just a fling. Okay, yeah, I feel like they're needing some time to make up a story on why somebody was in their life, why something is being revealed. It's like, oh, they weren't important. It was nothing. You know, that's why I feel like I need time. What do you need time for? To make up a story? For what? To see, you know, to see if the grass is greener on the other side? Because there's no grass that's going to be green with this energy. Okay, it's always going to be weeds with this energy. Your grass is going to be greener. Always. Because of how you operate spiritually, because of your soul. This person's soul is gonna get weeds. There's no green grass anywhere they go. Sorry, this energy is irritating. I feel horrible for hurting you. Yes, They should. There is so much I want to tell you. See, I feel like, what do they want to, what are they having planned? Look at, I'm planning on reaching out to you. What time do they need? You guys could be knowing what I'm talking about for some. Friends or family disapprove of this connection. Could be, you know, your friends or family, okay? Because if their family disapproves, it's because they're enabling this energy for sure. I mean, that's all I got to say. But yeah, I mean, this person, again, a knight will travel through. So this person could be coming back and forth all the time, okay? It's how now how you handle it, which I already feel you're going to be moving into new beginnings. Let's see how you're doing over here. See how Aries is doing. Let's see what type of energy you're holding. Oh, see, it gets better. Brighter days ahead, guys. Brighter days ahead in love. And it even has like this heart with band-aids on it. Okay. Yeah. Love that. Look at connect. Connect with people. Connect with spirit. There's so many like things that are here for you, and I feel like you're getting a lot of synchronicities. Yeah, movement. You're moving towards your wishes, your fulfillment, because everything is on your side, okay? Everything. I love this. I love you right here. Like, love this right here. The High Priest is just saying, hey, connect with the spirit. We got your back. We'll send you signs. Just ask us. So very beautiful there. And then let's see what else we have. Let your friends help you. Ask for and accept support from others. Okay. Anything else? Healing family issues. Your love life benefits as you forgive your parents. All right. And then very soon, clearly decide what you want. So that comes to you now. Very beautiful energy, Aries. Love it. Let's go ahead and pull a romantic oracle. Oh, look how pretty that is. Those look like jasmine flowers, huh? It says, criticizing one another will only lead you to further unhappiness. Love and accept each other as you are, and your relationship will automatically transform. And then we have, acceptance is the key to inner peace. At times, you must accept things as they are. There is no point trying to change that which is beyond our control. The universe, right, has your back. Remember that. Trust it. Believe in yourself. Believe in your intuition. That's what I feel the big message is here, is letting go of any type of control. And your intuition's on point. All right, guys, I'm going to leave it here. I really hope you enjoyed this reading, Aries. And if you did, please like and subscribe. And I will see you guys very soon. God bless.